Hi, this is Abid Kazmi for DCTV USA, and here are the major headlines.
The Pakistani origin critic of big tech companies, Lina Khan, has received US President Joe Biden's nod for the top post at the American antitrust regulatory body. In a move suggesting an aggressive posture on antitrust enforcement, the White House said it was submitting the nomination of Lina Khan, an associate professor of law at Columbia University's Law School, to the Federal Trade Commission, an agency with authority over some mergers and antitrust policy. Lina Khan previously served as counsel to the U.S. House of Representatives Subcommittee on Antitrust, which last year released a lengthy report suggesting grounds for breaking up giants such as Facebook, Google, Amazon, and Apple. The news comes amid a growing backlash against tech companies that have dominated key economic sectors and have seen their influence grow during the pandemic. More and more Americans are getting vaccinated, and the Biden administration wants to make sure that trend continues. The president is expected to announce a new coronavirus vaccine goal. The original goal of 100 million was reached last week on his 58th day in the office. Currently, on average, 2.5 million Americans are getting vaccinated per day. If that pace continues, Biden will very soon beat his 200 million goals. North Korea has carried out a second weapon test in a less than week, according to a senior US official. South Korea says two ballistic missiles fell into the sea between the Korean Peninsula and Japan. Japan's Prime Minister is calling it a threat to the peace and security of the country. North Korea warned the Biden administration to not raise a stink as the US Secretary of State visited Japan and South Korea to strengthen ties. Southeastern Australia is seeing a massive animal exodus caused by record-breaking floods. People are seeing a surge of creatures on their land as they try to find higher ground. Spiders in particular have been found in homes. People have also reported seeing trees full of snakes. Rains have impacted communities. According to New South Wales Premier, nearly 18,000 people have been forced to flee flood-hit regions in the state.
Thank you for watching. For more news and updates, please click on our link tree.